Dear students, welcome to your first English class. Hope everyone are fine and safe. Moving on, we all celebrate festivals, right? Eid, Diwali, Christmas, Ramzan. We all love to celebrate all the festivals. Each of us will have our own festivals. Most important part of any festival is sharing good things. Whether you share your greeting, maybe sweets, clothes, giving alms to the poor, it doesn't matter. But during festival, sharing is an essential part of celebration. Today we see about a little boy known as Hamid who love Eid. What is Eid? Eid is a festival to break the fast by Muslim. The name of the lesson is Eidgah. Now let us move on to the lesson. How wonderful and beautiful was the morning of Eid. The trees looked greener, the field more festive, the sky had a lovely pink glow, the sun seemed brighter and more dazzling than before to wish the world a very happy Eid. So, the morning was so wonderful and beautiful. The trees looked greener, the field more festive, the sky had a lovely pink glow, the sun seemed to be bright and more brighter than before to wish the world a very happy Eid. The village was filled with excitement. Everyone was up early to go to the Eidgah. The boys were more excited than the others. They had been talking about it all the time. Finally, the day had come and now they were impatient. They were taking their treasure out of their pockets, counting and recounting it before putting it back. Mahmud counted 1, 2, 10, 12. He had 12 coins. Mohsin had 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 15 coins. With this money, they would buy countless things, toys, sweets, paper pipes, rubber balls and much more. So, the whole entire village was excited on the day of Eid. Everyone was early to go to the Eidgah. Eidgah is a place where prayers offered by the Muslims on special occasions or festivals. The boys were more excited when comparing with others. They had been talking about the particular day all the time. And now they were impatient. They were taking their treasure out of their pockets. They kept on counting and recounting it before putting it back. Mahmud counted 12 coins totally. Mohsin counted 15 coins totally. So Mahmud and Mohsin had enough of coins. So through those coins they could buy things such as toys, sweets, paper pipes, rubber balls and much more. The next paragraph. The happiest of the boys was Hamid. He was only 4, thin and poorly dressed. Last year his father had died of cholera. Then his mother also died. From then, Hamid lived with his old granny Amina and was as happy as a lark. She told him that his father had gone to earn money and that his mother had gone to Allah to get lovely gifts for him. This made Hamid very happy. Hamid had no shoes on his feet. The cap on his head was soiled and tattered. He knew that his father would come back with sack full of silver and his mother with gifts from Allah. Then he would have more than Mahmud, Mohsin, Nuri and Sami. So, among the children, Hamid seemed to be very happy. He was 4, thin and poorly dressed. His parents have been died a year before. Hamid have been lived and taken care with his old granny Amina. She told him that his father had gone to earn money and mother had gone to Allah to get lovely gifts for him. This made Hamid very happy. He had no shoes on his feet. The cap on his head was soiled and tattered. Soil is dirty. Tattered is torn. So his cap was dirty and torn. He knew that his father would come back with sack full of silver and his mother with gifts from Allah. Then he would have more than Mahmud, Mohsin, Nuri and Sami. These things made Hamid so happy. Hamid's granny Amina was sad. It was Eid and she did not have even a handful of greens. If only her son were there, it would have been a different kind of Eid. Hamid went to his grandmother and said, "Granny, I will be the first to get back. Don't worry." Amina was worried. Other boys were going out with their fathers. How could she let him go to the fair all by himself? So, in this paragraph, Hamid's granny Amina was sad. It was Eid and she did not have even a handful of grain. So, the family was in poverty. They do not have sufficient amount of grain to cook and eat. If only her son were there, this would be a different kind of Eid for the family. Hamid went to his grandmother and said, "Granny, I will be the first to get back. Don't worry." Even though Amina was worried because other boys, they were going out for the fair with their fathers. But Hamid went all alone with his friends, with the accompany of the friends' fathers. Next paragraph. Hamid left with the other boys. Hamid was like one with the wings on his feet. They ran on ahead of the elders and waited for them under a tree. They reached the suburbs of the town. On both sides of the road were big houses of the rich. In the gardens, mango and lich trees were full of fruits. Then they came across the stores of sweet vendors, all decorated so gaily. Every store had sweets filled up in heaps like mountains. So Hamid left with other boys. Hamid was like one with wings on his feet. What is one with wings on his feet? He speedily ran away with other kids. They ran on ahead of the elders and waited for them under a tree. They reached the suburbs of the town. What is suburbs? Out of the city. On both sides of the roads, there were big houses of the rich. The gardens was filled with mango and lich trees. Then they came across the stores of the sweet vendors, all decorated so gaily. So the sweet shops were decorated so brightly and colorfully. Every store had sweets filled up in heaps like mountains.